What up, freaks? I tell you time and time again, real estate investing is wild. Real estate investing is dangerous, man. And we're going to be talking about this cat. This cat turned a normal eviction, if there's such a thing, okay? Like, no eviction is normal, honestly, right? Evictions can pop off and be dangerous and turn violent or turn deadly at any time, right? So there's evictions that go off without anything crazy. But, I mean, evictions are they're pretty gnarly, dude. Like, you go there, you're usually physically removing somebody. You're throwing everything they own in the street, well, on the tree lawn, or as it's called in some parts of the country, the Devil's Strip. That's a weird name. I always thought the Devil's Strip was on a late. Anyway, you know, the ladies, they got the little run. Anyway, we're not talking about the ladies. We're talking about evictions, and evictions are dangerous. And this particular eviction got a little wild, turned into a 3-hour standoff with the SWAT team, right? So stop looking up lady hairstyles in the nether regions and start paying attention right now. Welcome to the show, folks. My name is James Wise, and I am here. I am here to help you guys learn about real estate, talk about real estate, do what we do, folks. Bring you the worst of the worst, right? Because that's what we do, right? We do a lot of stuff, but on this one show here, the Tenants From Hell Show, it's all about the bad, man. It's all about the bad stuff. And I made this wonderful little slideshow for y'all, right? Because this cat right here, okay, this dude is getting evicted. Right, and evictions are wild, okay? This thing turns into a 3-hour standoff, right? Got this dude, he's the tenant. He's getting evicted. He ain't paying no rent. You got these guys, these handsome gentlemen, these officers, these men in blue. They're the SWAT team, right? This guy, Brian Erunski, 41. According to the article, right? I saw this article in, it was like patch.com or something. I linked it below, okay? According to the article, this dude, Brian Erunski, 41, he's a convicted felon out there in New Hampshire, where I wrote it down. Where is he living? Nope, I didn't write it down. Somewhere in New Hampshire. I think it was like Westchester or Manchester or something. I'll write it down. It don't really matter. But this guy. So apparently, according to the article, he's a convicted felon and he needed to get evicted, okay? And evictions can turn wild at any time. That's why when I talk to you guys, right, about tenant screening, property management tips, tricks, best practices, right, one of the things I always tell you is you don't rent to felons, okay? You don't do it. Now, is it possible that anybody could turn violent, could turn deadly? Yes, but a felon is giving you data, giving you analytics that is saying, hey, man, I might be more likely than the next guy to cause violence, to cause something dangerous like this, man. And, dude, I'm telling you, even when it doesn't turn into a 3-hour SWAT team adventure like this particular eviction did, right? Evictions are crazy, man. You don't believe me? Take a look at some of our evictions.
So where are the managers? No. We just got a report. There's a lot of people kind of squatting in here.
We're gonna give it to you. That's when I started hearing the butcher knife. And took a lot of bulbs out, hoping they, because it'd be dark in the motherfucker.
You can see that there's no window, like, right there, and this dog, like, we can't go in the backyard because there's a dog that will jump out and try to kill us.
Okay. Walking into an apartment that contained a tenant that the landlord was not able to evict.
I didn't say you had no problem with me going to the basement.
Come on, mom.
I never said you had a problem.
See what I'm saying? It's wild out there, dude. And that's just like, you know, the tip of the mountain of the crazy crap that happens if you're a real estate investor. Right? That's why it's so wild when people vilify the landlord for having to evict people. Like, dude, like everybody thinks the landlord's a bad guy. Do you see the crap landlords are dealing with? Like, it's insanity. And you know what? Just for shits and giggles, let's run another minute of some of our insanity that we've seen, and then I'll finish off this story.
Oh, got him.
No, I have 11 kids.
She spit on the sign?
Yeah.
Did you get it on camera?
Stop! Up, up, up!
Beautiful. Beautiful.
So we called this tenant and we're like, hey man, what's going on? The guy, you know, he's like denying it for a little while, but finally the guy admits that he gets really drunk, and he gets so drunk he passes out on his couch and just shits his pants. This is every day. He tells us that he just stacks his pants in the corner of his apartment, just filled with poop.
Alright, so if you're still with me, as I continue to discuss what happened here, what folks could learn from the scenario, you gotta be on the side of the landlord at this point, right? I'm so sick of all those wokies out there. Like, landlords are bad people. They just evict people and they make money. Did you see all the properties and what those houses look like and what those animals did to them? Like, dude, how does that make you money? It doesn't, right? Does stuff like this make you money? No, right? The goal of a landlord is to avoid the SWAT team having to come out, right? Look at all these sweet-ass photos they got. This eviction looked pretty wild, right? So this is all from that article I saw. The gist of what happened is that dude, Brian, allegedly, this is all alleged. I don't have any inside info other than what was publicly published, right? So this is what they're saying. But allegedly, he, you know, was being evicted, assuming he did not pay rent, right? So the normal eviction process that they handle out there in New Hampshire takes place, right? Here in Cleveland, where I'm at, a lot of that footage I just showed you, that's a lot of our stuff, right? Personal evictions here in the city of Cleveland, but also suburbs around. But the city of Cleveland is where the majority of our evictions happen, and we have bailiffs. They look like cops. They act like cops. They carry guns like cops. They will kick your fucking door down and shoot you like cops, right? As a matter of fact, you know, we just did another story in another Tenants from Hell. I'll post that below, you know. Cleveland bailiffs did shoot some motherfucker. They killed his ass, right? Because he was dangerous, right? And that's almost what happened here, right? So they go to serve the eviction, how they handle it. The guy refuses to come out. It comes to light that he's allegedly a felon. And there was fear that he had some guns in the house. So people were afraid. Locks, you know, all the people, they're scared, right? So they got a call on the SWAT team. This dude barricades himself into the house. It took them 3 hours trying to get him to come out. Did not work peacefully, so they had to breach through and actually go inside the house, you know, do the whole SWAT team action like you see in the movies. They found the dude hiding under a mattress, and they were able to physically restrain him and remove him from the property. Nobody was hurt. Nobody was injured, right? So that's what happened here. I know a lot of new investors out there. I deal with new investors all the time, and I get new investors out there that think, like, the actual eviction notice, like, removes people. Like, they'd be like, yeah, I gave the tenant a 30-day notice. I told him he had to leave. And they think that that little piece of paper will physically make them leave. No, no, no. That's just the start of the process. Sometimes you literally need fucking machine guns to make people leave, folks. This business can and will become dangerous or deadly if you're not following the proper procedures. And where it really starts is with your tenant screening. That's where I believe this landlord went wrong, right? Again, I said it earlier. Anybody can turn violent, can turn dangerous. Any particular person has the ability to turn into this, right? To become this SWAT team standoff story, right? But your violent felons, folks, they have already given you data that shows you they are more predisposed to it than others, right? When you're investing in real estate, there is an unlimited amount of variables at play at all times, okay? At all times. Our job As landlords, property managers, real estate investors, our job is to mitigate those variables, mitigate the risks as much as possible. Can we ever eliminate all risks? No, absolutely not. But with proper tenant screening, property management policies in place, you can minimize a lot of the stuff. You'll never be able to eliminate it to zero. But this guy, felon, right? So you already know he's predisposed to behave this way, right? So you get all the, again, the wokies, they're like, oh, but what if he changed his life? I know this one felon, and now he's a good person. Well, good for you, Carol. Who gives a fuck? If you want to save the fucking dolphins, save the fucking dolphins. But that's not what landlords are doing. Landlords are here to run a fucking business, not save the goddamn dolphins, man. So if you run proper tenant screening, all right, are you going to probably, through the grand scheme of things, deny housing to some felons who may have turned the leaf and could have possibly been good tenants or good people? Sure. But who gives a fuck? Your job is not to house every reformed felon in the world, guys. Your job is to mitigate your risks as much as humanly possible and minimize these types of situations. And it is tried, true, and proven that if you run proper tenant screening and you do not rent to violent felons or any type of convicted felon, these scenarios are less likely to happen than if you do. So I'm sorry to that population of people who did commit felonies and who now have found Jesus and are great people. Hey, man, from a moral standpoint, great job out of you, fellas. I'm so happy for you. But you're not going to rent a fucking house from me, okay? It's not going to happen. I ain't out here saving the dolphins. My job is not to fucking house you and make your life better. My job is to run an efficient and profitable property management business for myself and my investors and other investors out there who are just getting into the game. I implore you to put this thinking into your business. Remember, if you're good at your job, you are not so much as providing housing to everyone as denying housing to people that create an undue risk on your business, right? For every apartment you have, you should probably be denying like 10 people, right? Like for every apartment you got, right? There's gonna be all these people that want it. You gotta pick the one that has the least amount of risk factors, right? No felonies is a big one. That is a big tenant screening thing, right? So if you guys want more tenant screening tips, tricks, advice, things like that, I suggest you subscribe here to HoltonWiseTV. In addition, if you are interested in investing in real estate and you don't want to get into the sticky, icky, icky stuff like this and you don't want to deal with all that nastiness that I showed you earlier in the video, and you want to partner with a team who sold over $200 million in real estate, runs a $75 million real estate portfolio right now, and will handle all the dirty stuff like this and will make those decisions mitigating your risks so you don't have to be the bad guy who's not helping out every reformed felon in the world, you can go ahead and book a free call below. Talk to my team about how we can help you become a passive real estate investor. And on the off chance, we got to bring the SWAT team out to your property to remove a deadbeat, we'll be the guys on the front line while you can sit safely at home.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to Holton Wise TV for more financial information, education, and entertainment.